This video is based on a new meta-heuristic optimization algorithm named as all-member-based optimization algorithm. We can use this algorithm to solve different optimization problems. And in this video, we will try to understand what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, various steps used in this algorithm, mathematical models to update agent's position in the search space, and algorithm flowchart. Step by step, we will try to understand what is this algorithm all about and how we can use this algorithm to find out the optimal solution. First of all, you can see here all member based optimizer is introduced in 2021. It is the population based meta-heuristic optimization algorithm that we can use to solve different optimization problems. Author tested this algorithm on different benchmark test functions and also compare this algorithm performance with other meta-heuristics. All member-based optimizer provides better results as comparison with other meta-heuristics. Now you can see here algorithm main idea, that is make use of population matrix, and here all members can play their role in updating the population matrix. This algorithm is a little bit different than the other meta-heuristics that we already discussed. So first we will try to understand algorithm main idea, or you can say the inspiration behind this algorithm, so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working. As you can see here, we already discussed different meta heuristics inspired by animals, insects, birds, nature, plants, music, physics laws, human behavior, and other. For example, you can see here we have particle swarm optimization algorithm. It is a swarm intelligence meta-heuristic optimization algorithm that is inspired by the bird's flocking behavior. Here you can see we have a group of birds and they are randomly flying over an area and they are searching for the piece of food. And they don't know the exact location for this piece of food, but they know how far they are at each iteration. And the PSO search strategy is follow the bird nearest to the food. And you can see this bird is nearest to the food and other members are following this bird. So this bird is considered as the best solution. And you can see we have another bird, this one. Suppose it is far away from the piece of food. And this is considered as the worst solution. So in particle swarm optimization algorithm, when we will update the position for the other members, it is influenced by the best solution and the worst solution. So all members will update their position around best and the worst solution. So it is like the boundary. Like particle swarm optimization algorithm, other meta-heuristic also use this method to update agent's position in the search space to find out the optimal solution. They will update the agent's position around the best and the worst solution. So that is the main idea in this algorithm. Instead of using best and the worst solution, we will make more use of population matrix. And here we will use all members to update algorithm population. So this is the algorithm main idea, where we can use all members to update algorithm population to find out the optimal solution. For example, you can see in the chess game we have the target as the opponent king, and you can see we have different pieces. For example, you can see in the chess game we have the target as the opponent king and we have different pieces: queen, knight, bishop, rook, and pawn. Whether it is a queen that can move in all directions or a pawn that can make either two steps or one step, every piece is playing their own role. Like that in all member based optimization algorithm, we will make more use of population matrix, and where every member can play their role in updating the population matrix. Not only best and the worst solution, but every member can play their role in updating the population matrix. So this is the algorithm main idea. Now you can see we have different steps used in this algorithm. First, we will initialize the algorithm parameters and then we will initialize the population for the agents in the search space. After that, using cost function or objective function, we will evaluate the algorithm performance that we randomly initialized. After that, we will check whether the current iteration is less than maximum iteration or not. And then we will update the agent's position in the search space, and we will update the position for the best member. Here we will update the member's position using stage 1 and stage 2. After that, we will save the best solution in the memory, and then we will increment the counter. Again, we will check the stopping criteria. If stopping criteria is not met, then we will repeat this loop, else we will display the best solution that is found in the previous iteration. Now, step by step, we will try to understand this algorithm. First, we will initialize all the important parameters like dimension, that is also known as design variables, constraint, that is the problem constraints, search space boundary, lower bound and upper bound, cost function, that is the fitness function we will use for the population evaluation, and population size, that is the total number of search agents, current iteration, and the maximum iteration, that is how many times loop will repeat. After that, we will initialize the population randomly in the search space. Suppose we have 60 search agents, it means it is the population size. And then you can see the dimension, that is the design variables. We have 3 design variables. We know that matrix is collection of rows and column. Here you can see we have 3x3 matrix. We have 3 rows and 3 columns. As you can see here, now we will initialize the population for the 60 agents in the search space. Here you can see the population size is 60. Value for n is 60. This is the position for the first agent. Second agent, n is 60. So here, this is the 60th agent. And you can see here, we have design variable, that is the dimension 3. So you can see the 3 design variables x1, x2, x3 for each member, for first member, second member, and for nth member. So next you can see, suppose this is the population matrix for 60 search agents. You can see 60 is the population size and 3 is the design variable, that is the problem design variables for each agent. For first agent, second agent, and third and last agent. Next, using any cost function, we will evaluate the initial population. Here we will use any cost function, or we can say objective function, and we will calculate the fitness value for each agent in the current population. Suppose this is the fitness value for the first agent, fitness value for the second agent, and fixed and the fitness value for the 60th agent. After that, we will check whether the current iteration is less than maximum iteration or not. And then we will update the position for the members using stage 1. In the stage 1, we will update the member position by selecting the members in the population, as the algorithm main idea is we can use all member to update agent's position. As this is the algorithm main idea, we will make more use of population matrix, and here all members can play a role in updating algorithm population. In stage 1, we will update member position using all member in the current population. So first we will select the members. Here NS, that is the selected members. Here, suppose the population size 60, design variables 3, maximum iteration we have 1000, and using this equation we can select members. Here you can see n, that is the population size 60, t, that is the current iteration, suppose 1, capital T is the maximum iteration, that is 1000, and here you can see for first iteration selected member value 60. For 100 iteration, selected members value we found 54. For 500 iterations, selected member's value 30. For 900 iterations, selected member value is 6. So like that, we can calculate the selected members. And here you can see the loop, that is j is equal to 1 to ns. Ns is the selected members that we calculated here. So here j represents the selected member. You can see here, this is the selected member problem variable value. And here you can see this is the population member problem variable value. And here we will repeat this loop from 1 to selected member and 1 to the population size. And using this equation, we will update the position. Now here we will compare the fitness values for selected member and the ith population member. And then we will update their position. After that, this is the final position update for stage 1. Here you can see this is the new position that we found for each member. Here again we will compare the new fitness value that we obtained here, and the older fitness value for the current agent. If the new fitness value is better than the older one, we will consider the new position as old position. After that, you can see we have stage 2. In stage 2, we will update the position members using best member in the current population. So here we are using the best member to update the agent's position in the search space. Here you can see this is the new position that we will calculate for the agents. And here this is the best member value and this is the older value for the ith member and this is the older value. Here we will compare the fitness values for the new position and the older position. If the new position fitness value is better, then we will consider new position as older position. So this is the position update for members using stage 2. So this is the flowchart for this algorithm. First, we will initialize the parameters, create initial population, evaluate population using any fitness function, and then we will check the stopping criteria. After that, we will update the population using stage 1, and then using stage 2. And then we will check the stopping criteria. If stopping criteria is not met, then we will repeat this loop, else they will display the best solution that is found in the previous iteration. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.